on God, though?
Real shame that it came to this. Don't look over there, look at me. It's a real fucking shame. No? You like music? Huh? Me? I'm old school. I like opera. One in particular is called Pagliacci. You ever see it? Huh? Well, that too was a shame. It's all about broken trust, see? There's a guy named Canio. He plays a clown. And Pagliacci. Everybody around town thinks that Canio's a clown because he plays one. Like he's some sort of fucking joke because he plays a joker. Even his wife goes around his back. So you know what Canio does? Do you? La comedia y finale. Joke is fucking over, my friend.
What the fuck is that?
Oh, it's mozzarella surprise in the snack bag patty wax.
Yeah, but who the hell are you?
Brayden, the intern from NYU. What can I tell you, boss? We get a guy who'll get us coffee, pick up the dry cleaning, else we lug stooly corpses down to the marsh. If we don't even gotta pay him, he works for what you call him, college credits. So yeah, I just figured that maybe it'd be more fun to torture the guy to this. That sad clown opera speech and the music? Not the vibe, bro. Kid's got a point, boss. Changed up the music, it might be, a vibe. Hey, personally, I like the jock jams, but... Yeah, dude, the tracksuit and some jock jams? Total vibe. Hey, boss, you hear that? I got a vibe.
Well, I'm kind of in the middle of something, so maybe we could talk about the vibe later at the bistro.
That's gonna be an issue? I think the constant pasta is starting to shrink my pump, bruh. I'm trying to stay svelte, you know? So I got us a table at the Ben Stillery. It's this brewery slash distillery slash indie comedy venue that does small batch gin mixology, and they have a ton of vegan options.
No. We go to Caprice's Bistro, we eat spaghetti in a walk-in, and we discuss business.
Hear me out though, fam. I know that I'm just the intern and I've been here for like a couple of weeks, but I feel like the morale's kind of low, you know?
I got a few ideas on how to boost morale.
I mean, it's usually just you, eating spaghetti in the walk-in.
You never order anything.
I don't like eating spaghetti in a refrigerator. It's cold in there. And that table you sit at, boss, it's tiny. It's a tiny table.
You know, a toxic work environment can spin out of control quick. Less productivity, fear of reprisal, stifling innovation. You know, that sort of thing.
Yeah, dude. Totes.
I'm about to make an innovation by integrating my knife into your fucking neck. And then I'm gonna have Pauly roll you up in a tarp and drop you in a fucking swamp.
And that's another thing. Micromanagement. What's the motivation to climb the ladder here? It's more work for the same pay. Like, when's the last time anyone got a raise?
Well, it's not so much that we get paid. It's more of a cut from the crimes.
Oh, really? Freelance commission work?
Hey, everybody gets a fair cut. Plus, I provide free deli meat for our meetings, which I call meetings, M-E-A-ting.
I know that's not a profit issue, right?
The hell is that?
Tutti Frutti Pink Lemonade Sativa. It's Zoot, bro.
You know, gestures like free deli meat's fine, but when your staff is underpaid and feeding that toxic work culture that befalls a lot of workplaces, you could use the deli meat budget and help pay your staff more.
Oh my god, bro! Are you sure we gotta chop this guy up and toss him in the swamp? He reminds me of my boy Squam from FSU. He's kind of a fuckboy, but he's aye.
We ain't gonna stop the deli meat meetings. And if you don't shut the fuck up, both of you, you're gonna be sleeping with the fishes.
Are the fishes the goth dime that works at the Ben Stillery on Scotter days?
Oh, snap.
Yeah.
I'm done listening to this shit.
Anyway, I guess I'll have to talk to Brenda in HR.
HR? We ain't got no HR, you fucking dunce.
Then who am I FaceTiming RN, bro? Brenda! Hey, it's Brayden! What's up, girl? Anyway, so the boss was like pointing a gun in my face, right? And I was sort of like...
You know, the kid makes a few good points, boss. I think I'm with Brayden.
What?
You know... In all the years I've been working for you, you never once said anything nice to me. You never once remembered my birthday. You never gave me any positive reinforcement, like, hey, good job staying late and cutting all this guy's ears off. Yeah, and all you wanted to do is eat your spaghetti and your little walk-in, your tiny table. You know, you got so wrapped up in the organized crime that you forgot about the organized criminals. Forget about it.
I've worked some jobs like that. It's tough.
You too, Paulie? We came up together. We were like a family.
Bad managers always say, we're like family.
You know what? Fuck this. You deal with it.
Oh, on God, though?
You got the mozzarella sticks. Pick it up, pick it up. You got the chicken fingers. With the marinara sauce. It's called an appetizer plus.